Introducing to you first, batting out of the red corner. Wearing green camouflage, he weighed an officially 127 3/4 pounds. His professional record in 13 bouts stands at 11 victories and 2 defeats, 5 wins coming by way of knockout. Desde Tijuana, Baja California, Mexico, presentando Daniel Ramirez. And next, his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the blue corner. He wears yellow, trimmed in blue, and weighed in officially 128 pounds even. This professional is perfect in the ring. 22 victories, no defeats, 1 draw with 16 big wins coming by way of knockout. Presentando el orgullo de Juncos, Puerto Rico, here is Jayson Maravilla Velez. Once again, referee Thomas Taylor with the final instructions.
Boxer, chief second, everyone else out.
All right, belt line's a little high here. He's gonna be able to work in right here. Gentlemen, I'm giving your instructions in the dressing room. Remind you, protect yourselves at all times. Listen to my commands. Touch them up. Back to your corners.
And we get ready for our main event. Jayson La Maravilla Velez, 22-0-1. And there you see him on your screen against Daniel El Huracan Ramirez, 11-2 with 5 KOs. Ramirez, born in Mazatlan, Mexico, moved to Tijuana, then he moved to Las Vegas, now makes his home in Paramount, California. Puerto Rican in the blue and gold trunks. Ramirez going with the camouflage. Jayson Velez, 27 years old, and the last time he was in the ring, Doug, he was fighting for the IBF world title, and that was a draw in Nebraska.
It was kind of a moral victory, though, because most of us, most boxing fans, looked at Velez as a prospect, not as a contender, not as somebody who was worthy of challenging for the title, but he held his own.
Five fans, make sure you score each round tonight live. Go to throwdownfantasy.com/goldenboylive. Score the fights, get real-time fantasy scores. We're going to show you the scores during the fights. Yeah, we have some really good, knowledgeable fans in the first two fights.
You know how to score a fight. As a matter of fact, I think their scorecard was a little better than some of the official scorecards. But you know what, Velez, he proved a lot of people wrong in those 12 rounds that he went with Gradovich. Most folks thought that Gradovich would sort of overwhelm him in the late rounds because he's a rugged pressure fighter. But Velez said himself, he learned that he could take a punch and that he could hang with the guy with heavy hands. Learned that he could throw a lot of punches, threw more than 1,000 punches during that 12-rounder. And now he wants to show that he can do more than just throw punches and take a punch. He wants to show that he's a good boxer. He wants to show that he can evade punches and work his jab, which is what he's doing so far.
And that was the co-main fight, the undercard of Bud Crawford in Nebraska. And Jayson Velez is the fighter that most boxing scribes rave about or talk about. They know what he's capable of, but you're only watching him because most of his fights have been in Puerto Rico. So the quality of opponent. So he knows that he has to come to the United States. He's really excited to be on Fox 1 across the country as a main event fighter. For the first time, he's headlining a card.
Nice choice body shots from Velez, and that was something that he did against Gradovich. He's a very fluid puncher. He believes that he has better than average power, although he's not really known for his power. He's known for his athleticism and his boxing ability. He's keeping that right hand up, moving his head, and timing those body shots with the right hand really well.
Started boxing at the age of 11, Jayson Velez. That was a karate class. He's like, nah, there's no belts here. Here's some gloves.
Yeah, his dad was a Bruce Lee fan.
Bruce Lee fan had the nunchucks. So here you go. They'll trade the nunchucks for gloves. Good body shot by Jayson Velez. Good opening round between Velez and Daniel Ramirez. We're scheduled for 10 in the super featherweight division.
How do you get to the top?
Jayson Velez, the Puerto Rican. He got hit a couple times to the body by Daniel Ramirez. Velez corner asking him, do you feel that power?
Kind of nodded, yeah.
Like, was it strong?
Kind of shrugged, no.
Ramirez says his body work is his best tool, offensive tool in the ring. He's a tall, rangy fighter, but he likes to press his opponents. Doesn't always use his height and his reach to his advantage.
Good right hand from Velez.
Oh, that hurt him.
Staggered with a hurricane. Puerto Rican loading up on that right. A left drop. Ramirez.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Come here. All right. Let's go.
In his last fight, Daniel Ramirez was stopped by Eric Hunter. That was in November. That was in the sixth round. Jayson Velez said he wants a world title. Said he has to beat a fighter that puts on a show. And he's dropped Ramirez here. But the Ramirez, a tough Mexican fighter, fighting back.
Yeah, he landed two nice right hands. They got the respect of Velez. He maybe got a little bit overconfident after scoring that knockdown. He was ready to celebrate.
Mexi with his hands up, he's wearing the camouflage.
He may still get the knockout the way these guys are trading punches, but he's got to be careful in there.
Guys, watch those hands.
Ramirez has a lot of confidence in himself.
Velez said after his last fight, he learned he had to be more efficient with his punches that he's throwing.
Pushing.
Good stiff jab. That was another point of emphasis in this camp.
Hey, I love the body attack from both of these guys, but Velez's body shots are more accurate. And more power, more pop to Velez's punches, definitely.
Good right hand from Ramirez.
Body work continuing from Jayson Velez. More body work.
And Ramirez is not neglecting the body either. Both guys keeping a high guard, trying to keep those elbows in, trying to protect each other from body shots and uppercuts.
Get him up, Daniel. Get him up.
Ramirez has fought Guy Robb, and he lost. Eric Hunter and lost. Those are only two blemishes on his record. Tough fighters.
Oh, yeah, Eric Hunter, I would consider him a top 10 featherweight.
We saw what
contender.
He did last time.
Terrific talent out of Philadelphia. Guy Robb is a Northern California prospect. And in between those fights, he beat a guy named Aaron Garcia, who was an amateur standout.
Velez making a point of emphasizing the body. There he tagged him upstairs. Good round for La Maravilla from Puerto Rico.
Good round for fans. This has been some incredible action, and I'm impressed with Ramirez just surviving, but not just surviving, fighting back.
Time.
Good second round for Jayson Velez. This broadcast of Golden Boy on Fox is brought to you by Corona Extra, la cerveza más fina. And by Mexico, live it to believe it.
Let's watch this beautiful 1-2 combination from Velez. That right hand rocked him. Basically sets up this follow-up assault. Oh, it was a left hook that put Ramirez down. That left hook was the finisher. He was rocked earlier by a right hand.
It landed flush with that left hook.
See another angle. Beautiful shot. Yeah, just timed it right. Ramirez got up. We see him going down again to the seat of his pants. Ramirez kept his composure and fought back, though.
Yeah, Daniel Huracan Ramirez, the nickname Huracan was given to him by an old trainer in Tijuana when he was just walking in there. Said hurricane, that's what it translates to, the way he was moving around.
He showed us a little bit of that towards the end of the second round.
Yeah, as you would expect, Velez just sort of dominating.
Throwing more, landing more. 42%, that's a lot.
He gets tagged with a stiff jab by Ramirez. As Velez comes back, a good scrap.
Danny, watch the pushing.
Yeah, they're doing more fighting than boxing. Both guys, their styles coming into this fight is tall, rangy boxers. Obviously very competent boxers, but maybe it's that Puerto Rican-Mexico rivalry. Both guys are laying it out on the line. They're wearing their hearts on their sleeves. They're exchanging. And now it's becoming more about heart than skill.
Yeah, Ramirez went to the gym because he was getting bullied. And then he fought the bullies. Typical story. He stayed in the gym. And now he's in a tough scrap with Jayson Velez, and he's holding his own after getting dropped in the second.
He does not have...
Letting his hands go now here, Doug.
It doesn't have the talent, doesn't have the experience. Velez is a little bit sharper. But Ramirez is showing
that. Body shot.
Yeah, and those are hurting. They're slowing him down. He's taking them, but those lefts to the body are slowing him down.
He's loading up on those body shots, especially the left.
Well, Ramirez is showing he has the heart to stand in here with a top 10 featherweight contender.
Tijuana fighter. You expect that. Soft-spoken fighter, Ramirez, wears glasses, came into the fighter meeting like, okay, you're our main event tomorrow? I can see why now. This kid has heart.
Oh, he deserves to be in here. He's proven it.
Velez knows that in this division, it's loaded. We talked about the opening, and he mentioned the names. Gary Russell, Abner, Leo. As he gets tagged by a right by Ramirez.
You know what? Ramirez has found a home for that right
yes,
hand.
Yes, he has.
That's the one punch, that one power punch that he can land with regularity, and Velez needs to come up with an answer to that.
Oh, good one from Velez.
Well, that's one answer. Throw a right hand right back.
Right back at him. Because the heavier hands belong to the Puerto Rican.
But being a top 10 contender, I'd like to see him slip some shots or at least block them. Might be smart for one of these guys to take a step back and reestablish his jab.
Top of the bell, gentlemen.
They're going to have to do it in the next round.
Good scrap between Mexico and Puerto Rico. LA Fight Club. In downtown Los Angeles.
We had two-way action in round three, and Ramirez landing a straight right, straight down the pike, landed. I actually scored round three for Ramirez because of those right hands.
You gave it on to Ramirez. He landed some good ones. Go to the fourth, schedule for 10. Jayson Velez, the Puerto Rican. He's undefeated with one draw in the golden blue. Huracan Ramirez from Tijuana in the camouflage.
Ramirez mixing his punches up well to the head and the body, starting at the head and ending at the body. The jab watch to the head, stop, throw stop. A straight right to the body.
Accidental headbutt, no cut. Guys, watch your heads on the inside, all right?
Referee Tom Taylor letting us know accidental headbutt here in the fourth round. Body shot from Ramirez. Velez answers with one of his own. He is loading up on those body shots.
You can hear the difference in their punches. Velez,
like
yeah, definitely the guy with the edge and power, and I'm sure his corner told him that between rounds. Stay patient, stay composed, land clean shots, and he'll get results.
Something that Velez said, that with the Gradovich fight, he felt he could hang there. As he knows, he can hang with Selby and Gradovich. Lee Selby, the champion.
That's right. Lee Selby, just this past weekend, lifted the IBF title from Evgeny Gradovich. Lee Selby from Wales and is a very talented boxer. And Velez says he could beat Selby. He's a more active fighter, and he believes he punches harder than Selby.
Where do you guys have him ranked on Ring TV?
Selby's he's top five now, and Jayson Velez is actually our number 10 contender.
Number 10. Doug Fisher, of course, the editor of RingTV.com. Good scrap between Velez and Ramirez a minute to go in the fourth round. As Ramirez went down in the second. With a nice left hook from Velez.
Left hook. It was a beautiful shot, and I think Velez was convinced that...
it was over.
Yeah.
He got into the ring.
Right. He started celebrating. He climbed onto to one of the turnbuckles.
The Tijuana fighter came back with a lot of heart. Able to survive the second, landed some good shots in the third. Gets tagged with that left again.
Yeah, and he was wobbled a little bit. He did a two-step.
As Ramirez is taking some
heavy leather here in the fourth round, trying to get away from Velez. Velez goes back to the body. Good left hooks landed by the Puerto Rican.
Smart punt selection from Jayson Velez in this round.
Good round for Jayson Velez. At the closing seconds of the fourth round in downtown Los Angeles.
Jayson Velez lands a counter left hook, and you'll see the second view of it. It rocked Ramirez back a step or two.
Good right hand to open up the round for Jayson Velez. He's wearing the gold and blue.
That was a good comeback round for Jayson Velez. I thought he struggled a little bit in round three. He reassumed control in the previous round.
Jayson Velez, 22-0-1 with 16 KOs in his career. From Juncos, Puerto Rico.
And he knows he's in great position right now with his world rankings, and he's just a fight or two away from another shot at a title. Golden Boy might have him go up against Gary Russell, the holder of the WBC title, because he's ranked really high in that sanctioning organization. He's still ranked in the IBF. But he can't afford to have any sort of missteps tonight.
Yeah, he knew that coming in. Make sure to emphasize that with us.
Seems like he's regained his own composure, letting his talent show, letting his experience show.
Jayson Velez asked about a rematch. Regenovich said, nah, I only want to fight a guy who has a belt.
That's right.
Said he came out of that fight, even though it was a draw, and some people had different ways. The final decision was a draw. He said he learned so much more about him stepping up in competition and going up against the best. Especially when you come off the island, it's a different world.
And correct me if I'm wrong, it seems like he's more motivated about his own career than ever before.
He said he trained harder. He worked harder. Everything about it when he went back to the island was harder. As Ramirez was in a tough scrap his last one against Eric Hunter, and he felt against Eric Hunter, he got caught. He wasn't paying attention, and Eric Hunter with those heavy hands will do that to you. And that was a good scrap against Eric Hunter from Daniel Ramirez last November.
If you can hang tough with Eric Hunter for six rounds, you can pretty much hang tough with anybody for six rounds. We'll see if he can make it past six rounds with Jayson Velez.
Straight back.
We're in the fifth, scheduled for 10.
Velez is looking really good offensively speaking. I still see some flaws, though, defensively speaking. He did say that that was something he wanted to work on. And maybe we should give Daniel Ramirez credit. He's in there. He's winning his shots. He's not afraid. He's taking some risks, and it's paying off a little bit. I think he's losing this fight, obviously, but he's in it. He's making it a fight.
After going down in the second.
Dropping the bell, gentlemen.
You're right. Velez able to get hit. Leaves himself open.
Time! Right there. Good job.
This week, MLB on Fox Sports 1 returns. Rangers take on the Royals. Then it's baseball night in America. Angels against the Yankees. Or you'll get Pirates against the Braves. Or even an AL Central showdown between the Tigers and White Sox. Coverage begins this week on your home for baseball every Saturday. Fox and Fox Sports 1. We're going to go to Montreal. David Lemieux, Doug Fisher, you and I will be there working that fight June 20th. That is a tough one.
I can't wait. It's a toss-up fight. It's a beautiful mix of styles with the aggressive power punching of Lemieux and the very athletic, still aggressive stick-and-move style of Hassan Nadam.
That'll be on Fox Sports 2 June 20th as Ramon Ayala jams throughout the Belasco Theater. Crowd's fired up. There's Jayson Velez, the Puerto Rican. Dropped Daniel Ramirez in the second round, but Ramirez able to compose himself, get back into this tough scrap.
Yeah, I think he's getting a tougher fight than he expected that time.
Velez? Yeah.
Yeah, I don't think Velez, I don't know if he expected to blow out Ramirez, but I think he came in here fully assuming that he was going to be in complete control to start to finish and would just outclass
him. Yeah, not an arrogance, just more of
I think just belief in himself, confidence. He's not an arrogant guy, but he was just beaming at the fighter meetings, and he was talking not so much about Daniel Ramirez, but about his own future.
Yep. Not overlooking Ramirez, more of a, I know I can beat this guy, and what's next for me?
And Ramirez has come out here and made a little statement.
We told him in the fighter meetings, look, if you upset Jayson, which would be an upset, you know that you can get into the mix to fight some of those top 10 guys. He didn't quite understand that the significance of what was on the line. His eyes just opened up behind those glasses. Like, really?
Yeah, I think he knew that Velez was somebody with a bit of a name. I don't think he knew that this guy was ranked by everybody. Exactly.
Sometimes there's the fighters who just say, give me the gloves. Where am I going?
Yeah.
He said, oh, okay, well, thanks for telling me. Oh, a good left from Ramirez.
You know what? Ramirez doesn't have the tightest technique, but I love that he commits to every punch he throws.
Oh, he is a scrapper.
And his technique is actually pretty cool. It's just, he's not a textbook technician. He does wing it a little bit.
Yeah, this time Velez is keeping that right hand up. As Ramirez trying to go back home, gets tagged again with that left hook. That quick left hook, that short one.
So earlier in the fight, Ramirez found a home for his right hand. Now he's finding a home for the hook. Oh, man, again.
Third time in a row, right?
Third time this round that the Puerto Rican is getting caught with that left hook.
Let's see if Ramirez can put something behind that hook.
Right.
Or mix it up a little bit, you know, do a lead right left hook. Or an uppercut left hook. He's got to be feeling pretty good about himself in this round so far.
Moving around with that bounce is Daniel Ramirez.
And Velez has got to be a little frustrated. He's got to be like, man, I was supposed to kick your butt. What's going on here?
Well, as Velez even said, in Puerto Rico, the quality opponents that he had coming up weren't on that level. He was going through fighters. Shot from the Puerto Rican. It's been his bread and butter tonight. Lands a left. Good fight between Velez and Ramirez.
Hey, Ramirez is in this fight. I scored that last round for Ramirez on the strength of these big left hooks. Boom, right to the ear of Velez. And later in the round, this is another left hook. You see how wide and sweeping they are, but he times them right, and he's landing.
Let's go to Jessica Rosales with more.
Yeah, guys, definitely a lot of action going on in the ring, but another fighter that promises action on July 11th at the LA Sports Arena, Mikey Perez. First off, that's going to be a big fight for you. Tell us about that night and what it means to you.
I mean, it's a step up. You know, it's a long time coming. It's a title eliminator. And I'm coming, man. I'm coming so the world can see me and for me to make a name.
Now, as a fighter, when you watch a fight like this that is action-packed, are you ready to get in the ring? Are you thinking what they should and shouldn't be doing? How do you watch this as a fan?
Oh, yeah, most definitely. I mean, I watch it as a fan. I know a lot of the fighters that's fighting here. But, you know, it gives me the motivation to get in there and get back to the gym and head forward to that July 11th fight.
All right, we'll be seeing you then, July 11th at LA Sports Arena.
Mauricio Herrera, Hank Lundy is the main event. Also, a lot of fighters that we've seen here at LA Fight Club. Jason Quigley, Chimpo Gonzalez, Jesus Ivan Delgado, and Nick Arce will also be on that card at the historic Sports Arena.
That's going to be a great card. It's going to be a lot of fun.
A lot of fun is this fight. We're in the seventh, scheduled for 10.
Yeah, it really is. I still have Velez ahead on the scorecards, obviously. He scored a knockdown in round two. I gave rounds 1, 2, 4, and 5 for Velez, but Ramirez is in this fight. I scored rounds 3 and the last round for Ramirez.
In his last fight, Jayson Velez threw almost 1,100 punches. He said he wanted to be more conservative with this one, maybe in the 700 level. He's on that pace.
He's on that pace, yeah. No, he lets his hands go, which is why he's a lot of fun to watch. He's showing us why he's a contender. He's got a great shin. I mean, those were some big left hooks. They landed, they moved his head a little bit, did not hurt him at all.
Keeps coming.
And he's got excellent conditioning
to be able to throw all these punches, but he's got some flaws. He's there to be hit.
He also did say in that Gradovich fight, what did he learn? I learned I could take a punch. He's showing us that tonight as Ramirez able to land three good hooks in the last round.
That can be a good thing, and it can be a bad thing for a young fighter.
How so?
Well, you don't want to rely on your chin.
Okay. Yeah, well, for sure you don't want to rely on that chin.
You don't want to go into a fight saying, yeah, I could get out of the way, but I don't have to. Because I could take a good shot.
You don't have that Chavez Sr. granite chin.
Well, it's not good for any fighter, even if you do have a block of granite for a chin. You want to move your head. You want to evade as many punches as you can. You want to make them miss. You want to make them pay. And you know, we can tell from talking to Velez, he's a smart young man. He's obviously got natural talent. He's got that amateur background. He's got the pro experience. He could get out of the way of these shots.
He could.
I mean, if he really made a concentrated effort.
Well, let's go back to what he told his corner after the first round. I asked about the power that he felt, kind of shrugged it off.
Right. So that's kind of an attitude,
sort of a machismo that he's bringing into the ring.
Jayson Velez, good combo. And the UCLA blue and gold. Daniel Ramirez went down to the second, dug deep, trying to get back into this fight, able to land some good shots.
Going back to the hook, Ramirez is. Although I can tell that Ramirez's punches have slowed down a lot. Velez still has his hand speed despite his active work rate.
Good right hand from Velez. Daniel Ramirez stays right there and takes it.
Stop the bell, gentlemen.
Jayson Velez in the corner, dancing around. Look at that. Showing the moves. Turned down for what? He's feeling it. He told them he already punished them. Now it's time to put the combos together. Throw that jab, the upper, throw that right hand. The instructions he's getting from his trainer, Rivel Mulero. Look at Velez in the corner just dancing, working the crowd. He's feeling pretty good about himself, and he's in a scrap. There you go. Put on a show, kid. And Daniel Ramirez is doing the same. Ramirez across the way, he put his hands. Look at Victor Cruz a la salsa there, even though it wasn't a salsa song. Got to get the Giants reference in any time you can.
So Velez not showing lateral movement in this fight, but showing that he does have some fancy footwork.
Yeah.
When it comes to dancing.
With the dance off, and now you're in the middle of the ring swinging it. Velez dancing, trying to get the crowd, and what happens? A Ramirez chant breaks out.
Well, we are in Los Angeles.
You are in L.A.
This is Baby Mexico, as a famous fighter once called it. But that showboating, the dancing, it seems to have sort of woken Velez up, kind of gotten him into his rhythm. He's moving his head a little bit more. I like that. Letting the hands go with that fluidity that he has.
Gets caught.
Still getting caught, though. And I got to wonder, whatever happens, you know, if he wins by decision or if it's a knockout or whatever, I'm wondering what the hardcore fans out there in the Twitterverse and social media are going to say about Jayson Velez, because Ramirez was an unheralded opponent coming in here, and Velez made the choice, going off his last performance, to stick with a young trainer, Adbiel Mulero, yep, who's not really well-known, and his head trainer for his fight against Gradovich was a well-known trainer, Abel Sanchez.
Yep.
And he trained here in Southern California in Big Bear prior to that fight.
Where Triple G at?
Yeah, Triple G, the famous Gennady Golovkin. And in previous bouts, I believe Velez had been trained by Freddie Roach,
Hall of Famer
and Trainer of the Year. So I wonder if fans are going to say, you know, he should have stuck with the world-class opponents instead of going with a lesser-known guy.
That's a great point. Jessica, what are they saying in Ramirez's corner?
So expect Ramirez to be a lot more aggressive, but not careless. They said that right now they just want to close this fight out strong. He's going for the knockout from here on out till this fight ends. And they said he's going to be very smart about his punches. He's not just going to throw carelessly. He's going to think them through.
And Ramirez asked them, you know, as you do in fighter means, what do you have to do to win this fight? None of this little shyness about it. I need a knockout.
Well, he needs a knockout on my scorecard to win. Velez has reassumed control of this bout in the previous round, and he's continuing it here in round eight.
Body work from Jayson Velez. That was his bread and butter early in the fight. And there he's standing and trading. Good round. Action-packed fight.
Yeah, he's letting his hands go, but unlike in previous rounds, here in round eight, Velez is moving his head and moving his upper body, and he's causing Ramirez to miss more.
Final seconds of the eighth round.
Stop the bell, gentlemen. Time.
Saturday.
Ramirez, big. Arcing overhand right lands from Ramirez, but round eight belonged to Jayson Velez. He put his punches together. Blocked punches and came back with his left, with his right to the body, with the left hook to the head and to the body. Far more active of the two in round eight was Jayson Velez.
And there you see Daniel Huracan Ramirez. Been a great scrap all night long. Had a dance-off between rounds. Back to the action here in the ninth. We're scheduled for 10. 128 pounders going after it. We were talking earlier today, though, that division is just packed.
Oh, yeah. I mean, and some elite talent, too. Yeah, and we didn't even name Vasyl Lomachenko, the WBO belt holder, Nicholas Walters.
That's another.
I mean, he's undefeated, a giant for the featherweight division. He's got technique and
power.
We
saw him together.
The fact that Velez is ranked number 10 is not a comment on Velez's talent. It's a comment on how deep that division is. I mean, it says something to be ranked at all.
And then you got the veterans like Abner Mares. He's still here.
Abner Mares, Leo Santa Cruz.
Santa Cruz is expected to step up in weight very soon.
Body work from Velez. Another body shot from Jayson Velez.
Yeah, I think he's wearing him down to the body, and I believe he's sensing it. And Ramirez's game. I mean, no quitting this guy.
Let him go, Danny. Good job, guys.
Being bullied is what got him into the gym at age 14.
He only had 17 amateur bouts, but this guy, I mean, he was born to fight. And he's proving it. No one's ever going to bully him again.
No. You don't want to. He takes a big left from Jayson Velez.
He's just got so much spirit.
Another fighter that's at that Fonse gym.
Yeah, a lot of talent and a lot of heart training at Ponce de Leon's gym in Montebello, California.
Good combination from the Puerto Rican.
And Ramirez is showing that he could take a shot. He's showing a big heart, but he's taking more punishment in this round than any of the previous rounds.
Including
round two, because if you remember, he got up and fought back in round two. He's got to get his hands moving.
Stay with us. Coming up next is FIFA Under 20 action, World Cup Austria against Argentina. On Fox Sports 1, keep it here. 25 seconds to go in the ninth round. It's been a good one since the opening bell between Jayson Velez and Daniel Ramirez.
Yeah, I have Velez firmly ahead in this fight. He's been in control for the majority of rounds, but it's been an entertaining fight because of the heart of Ramirez and some of the defensive holes of Velez.
Danny, as they call him in his corner, showing a lot of heart as we're going to go to the 10th and final round.
Round one.
venue.
You need a knockout.
Hey, last round, we're going to touch gloves in the center. How you feeling? All right. Make sure you guys get that, all right?
Es el último, güey. Es el último. Tienes aquí para que se deshacen las manos. Lo míralo.
Give me water. Look at him. He's already done. Keep your hands up. Last round. We get going. Velez in the corner asking the fans get going. He's fired up. A little holster out there. Hand to the ear. Real simple in the corner for Ramirez. Doug, you need a knockout.
I think they know that just going the distance with Velez is a moral victory. They prove that their guy can go 10 rounds with an unbeaten top 10 contender, and that'll go somewhere. I mean, he will be brought back for fights because he's proved that he's not just a durable game opponent.
He's not laying down for anybody.
Yeah, Ramirez is somebody who makes for good fights.
Action. That's what you want on TV. Yeah,
and so is Velez.
Velez is a high-volume, high-action boxer-puncher, somebody who is aware of the crowd, plays to the crowd.
They told Velez, keep the hands up. He didn't. He got caught with the left.
I'm liking Velez's form in these final rounds of this fight.
Staying aggressive, huh?
Yeah, he's aggressive, but he's moving his head, he's moving his body, and there's a nice punch selection. He's punching in combination, and he's never neglecting the body.
Keeps going downstairs, focusing on the head right now because it's there for him. And you see he's getting out of the way of these shots that he wasn't getting out of the way of earlier in the fight
when he was getting hit with those left hooks.
And before those left hooks, he was getting hit by those straight rights. And he's better than that, and he knows it.
Yep.
And he's showing it, finally.
Yeah, work on it, guys. Your hands are free. Let him go, Danny.
Been a good overall scrap.
Yeah, not that I'm complaining about the give and take, because this has been a fun fight to watch.
You're not going to complain, Doug Fisher?
Not me. I'm a bloodthirsty ghoul. I like action. I don't like to see fighters get hit too much. I don't like to see fighters get hurt.
But competitive, which is this fight has been.
I don't mind a little bit of blood. I don't mind some give and take. I don't mind a little. I don't mind rock'em sock'em robots and spots.
What you want.
And neither do most fans.
Ramirez was down in the second and wobbled. Stunned a couple times in the middle of the fight. Dug deep, came back in. We're less than a minute to go in the scrap. As Jayson Velez continuing to work the body, the Boricua fighter. Gets tagged with an uppercut, though.
Yeah, but he still has all the confidence and momentum here in the 10th and final round. And I don't think that we've mentioned it, but I think this is uncharted territory for Ramirez. He's never been 10 rounds.
No, he hasn't. Jayson Velez, the first fight he ever saw as a youth, as a kid in Puerto Rico. Tito, Oscar. That got him hooked, took him to the gym. After that, he's never looked back. And he wants a chance to fight for a world title again. He was there once, ended up with a draw, said he's a different person now. He's grown as a boxer. He showed tonight that he's a fighter. He's making a name for himself with a big right hand.
Stop. And that'll... Straight back. Stop.
Ramirez holds on. We go the distance in a good fight between Jayson Velez and Daniel Ramirez. An entertaining fight all 10 rounds. We'll come back with the decision in Los Angeles. And there you see downtown Los Angeles. Coming up next, the FIFA Under 20 World Cup, the group stage, Austria and Argentina. Let's go back to this fight. Check out how it started early on, Doug.
Well, Beto, Jayson Velez thought he would blow Daniel Ramirez out of the water, and in round two, it looked like that's what would happen. Dropped him with that big left hook. Ramirez goes down to the seat of his pants. Velez jumps up in celebration. But guess what? Ramirez was not finished. He got up and he fought hard till the final bell. But if you look at the punch stats there, Jayson Velez landing almost 40% of his total punches.
And here's how the fans scored it. They gave it all to Jayson Velez.
I see it like that. I got a 98-91 for Jayson Velez. Two rounds for Ramirez, but Velez dominated this on the scorecards.
Let's get the result from Joe Martinez.
Gentlemen, after 10 rounds of boxing in this main event, brought to you again by Golden Boy Promotions and Miguel Cotto Promotions, we go to the judges' scorecards. Zach Young has it 99-90. Both judges, Wayne Hedgepeth and Dr. Lou Moret, 98-91. Your winner by unanimous decision, se mantiene invicto and still undefeated, Jayson Maravilla.
There you see, unanimous decision. Jayson Velez improves to 23-0-1 with 16 KOs. For just-